Hello. Today we bring forth to you our presentation on an intelligent steering system. I am Swati Sridhar and Nivedita and I will be running you through the presentation while Sanjana and Pranav will be doing the demonstration. A brief on what the contents are available in this slide. Starting with the introduction, moving on to the abstract, then the aim and the objectives, and the block diagram, the list of hardware and software used, methodology, experimental results, societal relevance, conclusion and future scope, and the publication and commercialization of the product and the targeted users. So, as to the introduction, autonomous driving is becoming very, very widespread in today's world. Steer-by-wire system is relatively a new development and isn't very conventional. Saying conventional, the hydraulic, electric, or mechanical steering systems used in the automotive industry turn out to be a little obsolete in comparison. Traditionally, the steering methods used uses a mechanical linkage between the steering wheel and the front two wheels of the car. Like we see, the steer-by-wire system has become significantly more interesting as a research subject due to its one most important character, which is to reduce the mechanical components involved in the steering systems, which mainly is the rack and pinion system. The steer-by-wire system promises an improvement in vehicle safety, the dynamics, and stability, along with a lot of comfort. As we all know, drinking and driving is one of the most hazardous problems we have as today's road safety is concerned. Drunk driving accidents account for nearly 1.5% of all the road accidents that happen, according to a particular data set by NCRB. You can see the graph around here, which shows us the statistics of drunken driving cases in India. As many as 42% of the victims of drunken driving accidents died. This is significantly higher compared to that of overspeeding, reckless driving, or weather conditions for that matter. What we propose to do here is bring about an alcohol detection system in the car using a sensor so that the safety of the people driving inside the car is ensured. This system is largely dependent upon the content of alcohol in the breath of the person driving, and it gives a particular limit as to what speed this driver can drive, depending on the amount of alcohol he's consumed. Moving on to the abstract, a steer-by-wire system largely aims to eliminate any form of physical contact between the steering wheel and the wheels of the car itself. The change in wheel direction of the car is controlled electrically and provides the driver with the feedback. The steering wheel is easily modifiable and allows different drivers to be able to adjust their comfort level. And like we all know, each person has their own style of driving. So naturally, this system is very user-friendly. The main focus of this work is to use the NIMIRIO to describe a control method for a steer-by-wire system according to the requirements of the vehicle steering functions. The other avenues of this work also recommended interfacing alcoholic sensor for real-time speed control, thus ensuring the driver safety. For now, to test this system, we are building a prototype with a self-assembled robotic car so as to obtaining satisfactory results. The aim of our project is to develop an intelligent steering system using the NIMIRIO to eliminate the conventional rack and pinion mechanism and to interface a breath analyzer to detect alcohol consumption and control the speed of the vehicle. Our objectives are to eliminate the conventional rack and pinion mechanism for better driving experience and increase the fuel efficiency. Then, to ensure the safety of the driver when he's intoxicated. And lastly, to make the NIMIRIO as a complete standalone device. Now, Nivedita will be taking over.
Hi, Nivedita N will be taking you through the methodology of the system we have used here. Figure 5 shows the block diagram of the system we have proposed for the mentioned problem statement. In this system, a MyRio is mounted to the steering wheel of the car. MyRio consists of inbuilt CAN, which cuts down the need of multiple CAN in the system. There are two channels in MyRio with 33 pins each, and a separate channel for DAC, which makes it act as a standalone device. To this MyRio, we are giving signals obtained by inbuilt accelerometer, which helps in determining the steering angle. The output obtained from the alcohol sensor is also given as input to MyRio. The signals from accelerometer and alcohol sensor are used to determine the direction and speed of the car, which is given as input to motor drivers. Motors are powered using LiPo battery. The motor driver sends the required RPM to the wheels, helping in achieving expected movement of the car. The components we have used for designing the system are: the hardware includes NI MyRio, MQ3 alcohol sensor, HT12E encoder, HT12D decoder, HC05 Bluetooth module, Arduino, LM293D motor driver, LiPo battery. The software which we have used here include LabVIEW for NI MyRio configuration, Arduino for wireless communication. In the next few slides, we'll be explaining the methodology in detail. The inbuilt accelerometer values are measured, which in turn gives the steering angle. These values are then converted into 4-bit digital data, which is encoded and transmitted with the help of a Bluetooth. The data is decoded at the receiver end. The receiver end includes the wheels. From the accelerometer, the axis values for all the steering angles are taken, and a lookup table is built to transmit the equivalent bits. For every angle, the driver rotates the steering wheel. The angle is compared with the lookup table, and the equivalent bits are encoded and transmitted at the receiving end. Figure 6 shows the proposed system steering wheel with MyRio and the angles it is divided into. The steering wheel can rotate up to 90 degrees both towards left and right. The point at which X and Y axis meet is where the MyRio kept. The point, we call it as reference point, which is at 0 degrees. Now we'll see how bits are transmitted according to the steering angle. The encoder we have used here is 4-bit data encoder. So the entire steering wheel is divided into 16 parts, which makes 8 parts each on the left and right side. Since the entire steering wheel is 180 degree flexibility to rotate, we divide 180 degree with 16, which gives us 11.25 degree. Thus, for every change in 11.25 degree in steering angle, the next bit is enabled and transmitted accordingly. Figure 7 and 8 shows how bits are generated based on the steering angle when it is rotated towards left and the right turn. Now, we'll see how wheels of the car are rotated based on the steering angle. The RPM of the motor is based on 4-bit data received from the receiver through MyRio. LM293D has capacity of providing maximum RPM of 255. The maximum angle of the steering is 90 degrees. Thus, each side is divided into 8 parts of 11.25 degrees. Therefore, if we divide 255 by 8, we get 31.8, and approximating that is 32. Thus, for every 11.25 degree change in steering angle, the RPM is changed by 32. The graphical representation of RPM change is shown in figure 9 and is observed to be a linear graph. As a safety feature to the car, we have installed alcohol sensor, which is used to measure the toxicity of driver. The MyRio programmed in such a way that it enables the driver to drive based on the amount of alcohol consumed. If the driver is found to cross the maximum threshold, the car will be impossible to start. Now, we'll see how the safety measure of alcohol sensor is used to control the speed. Based on the percentage of alcohol consumed, we have divided it into four cases, being 10 to 30% of consumption, 30 to 60%, 60 to 80%, and 80 to 100% of consumption. As we know, cars will contain some air fresheners and other odors too, which can result in a range of 0 to 10% alcohol detection. Thus, 0 to 10% is taken as tolerance. PWM signals are generated for each case. Duty cycle is max, that is 1 for tolerance range. For other cases, as the percentage of alcohol increases, duty cycle decreases towards 0, which results in reduction of speed in vehicle. When percentage increases, exceeds threshold, the duty cycle becomes 0 and the car is forced to stop.
So talking of the experimental results, taking a look at this graph, it shows the accelerometer data plotted with respect to time for both right and left turns. The z-axis represents the inclination of the steering wheel, which is maintained constant. The x and y axis represent the direction in which the steering is rotated. The reference point for the steering is taken at the point where the x and y axis meet. Here, we see that the steering is rotated about 90 degrees towards the right, and the x axis increases and the y axis decreases, as we see in figure 11. And when the steering is rotated 90 degrees towards the left, the y-axis increases and the x-axis tends to decrease, like we see in figure number 12. The alcohol sensor was also tested using different concentrations of alcohol. The output coming from the alcohol sensor was in terms of ohms. The system was tested for every 20% increase in the alcohol. The graph shows a sensor output in ohms versus the percentage of alcohol consumption. These are a few images of our prototype showing the model car, the steering wheel, and an image of how the system is assembled. Talking of the societal relevance, it is a huge shift from the mechanical system to an electrical system. The steer-by-wire is an implementation that is really promising in terms of handling, functionality, and the safety of the car can also be improvised. Nivedita will continue.
The conclusion that can be drawn from all the slides that we have seen previously are the steer-by-wire system does not only create free space in the engine compartment by eliminating the steering shaft, but it would also reduce the amount of vibration felt in the car and create a much safer environment for the driver. The main focus of this work is to use NI-MyRio to describe a control method for a steer-by-wire system according to the requirements of the vehicle steering functions. Though the steer-by-wire system is already implemented in high-end cars, the new approach of using NI-MyRio opens up the possibility of integrating more analog and digital sensors to the system, resulting in many innovations and research. The system also has successfully demonstrated the ability to control the speed of the vehicle by detecting and identifying alcohol consumption. Future scope. Given that commercial steer-by-wire systems are many years in the future and there are still a number of problems that needs to be solved, the implementation of wired technology seems like an ideal area for academic research. Since steering is the primary means by which a driver can control a vehicle's motion, steer-by-wire opens many possibilities for investigating advanced steering control algorithms. The flexibility of steer-by-wire serves an entire range of research purposes, from replicating the driving dynamics of a conventional vehicle to lane-keeping assistance to fully automated operation. To produce good handling responsiveness requires not only precise steering control, but also smooth feedback signals. Coming up to the publication, the paper entitled Intelligent Steering System has already been submitted to Journal of Advanced Research in Dynamical and Control System on 12th June 2020. Commercialization of the product and targeted users. Commercialization of the product can be done only after integrating more sensors to the system. The targeted users are all automobile industries that we can see around. We have come to the end of the presentation. Thank you for your time and patience.